Vivekananda Kendra, Mananiya Balakrishnan ji to formally welcome all.
Om Shri Ekakshara Mahaganapate Namaha. Hari Om Namo Narayana. Suswagatam Suprabhatam. Very happy to meet all of you here on this very important occasion of inauguration of this Sabhagriham and Annapurna. Our founder, Sabhagriham Ekanaji Rande, was a great visionary. After the construction of the Vivekananda Rock Memorial, he started a service organization named Vivekananda Kendra, a spiritually oriented service organization to carry the message of Swami Vivekananda to the nook and corner of India. Ekanaji used to say, "My mission in life is to carry the quintessence principles of man-making and nation-building of Sanatana Dharma." And Vivekananda Kendra is just completed 50 years of its existence and carrying number of service activities to propagate Swamiji's message. For some time we have been thinking that there should be a proper meeting place for all the Hindu organizations in Kanyakumari. Kanyakumari is the Mooladhara of Bharat. From here the energy emanates and it spreads throughout the nation. Whenever the energy from Mooladhara has emanated, had spread all over, that time India was Akhand Bharat. When the energy started deteriorating, the degradation of our country also has taken place. So it is our duty to see that this great pilgrim center, Kanyakumari, is a very important place where all the Hindu organizations will come and have their deliberations. They should feel at home. Ekanaji used to say, all the Hindu organizations should come, there should be a meeting place. So that is why this auditorium was built. Because it is a dream of Ekanaji. So today we are very happy to inaugurate this auditorium and the Annapurna, Annaksharam. Our Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, Sri R. N. Ravi, and Madam Ravi, both are present here. About a couple of months back, I had met him in Rajbhavan. First, it was a courtesy call for about 10 minutes. Afterwards, again, I requested him, "I want to have a one-to-one talk with you." So, he gave me an appointment and gave me 1 hour and 10 minutes. I had interaction with him. So, I was so much surprised. A governor could give so much time to talk to me. So we interacted about our activities in various places and also the problems facing in different areas. So today we are very fortunate that he has come here. Sir, I welcome you on behalf of Vivekananda Kendra. Adaniya Sarasanthi Kalak, he is not a stranger to us. You know, when Ekanaji passed away, on 22nd August 1982 for the cremation, then Sarasankhya Chalak of the RSS, Balasar Devres had come. Next day morning, that is on 23rd morning, before leaving the Vivekananda campus, he called me and Dr. Kanyakumari. She was president at that time, working president at that time. And he told, "No, 890 is no more. Lot of problems will be there. But the organization has to be run by the people chosen by 890. You have new people have to manage it. But many times, any help you want from the Sangha, Sangha is always there with you." Since that time, Kendra has been always closely meeting the Sarasangha Chalakji and other adhikaris. And all our activities are done with their cooperation. And Mohanji's guidance, if we get it, every year he comes. He comes for 2 days and sits with us, very informal discussion. We get so much inspired by that. So we are very happy that he is in our presence today. And he will definitely inspire all of you during his talk here. Our Swami Chaitanya is our own person. There is no need for a separate welcoming. He is our own member of the organization. His Guru, Swami Bhutarandiji, was associated from the very inception of the Vivekananda Rock Memorial Committee. At that time, it was known as Swami Vivekananda Centenary Celebration Committee. He was there and he was our general body member also. So, Vallimalai Ashram is always with Vivekananda Kendra. And Swami comes every time. And we are very happy that Madam Governor also is here. Last time also she came. They came with the family. The children were here. They stayed here. They visited the Vivekananda Rock Memorial and the Ramayana Darshan. And we are also having, fortunately, Bhaiyaji is here. Bhaiyaji Joshi, I will say it is a bonus point for us. Because you were supposed to be in Rameshwaram. So you have come here. It is a great moment for us. I want it is the request of all our workers that Bhaiyaji should stay here for some time. And all our other adhikaris, Thanu Aren ji, Rajendra ji, Sandil ji, they are all our own people. So only thing I want to say is that the Vivekananda Kendra is the meeting place for all the Hindu organizations who are working for the betterment of the nation and Hindu Dharma, for which Ekranji Ranade stood. So, I am very happy. I welcome all of you for this program. And I thank those girls who gave this Vande Mataram, especially Tamil Nadu girls, the pronunciation Uchcharan was so good. I thank them also. I thank the principal for arranging this. Thank you very much. Vande Mataram.
I request the General Secretary of Vivekananda Rock Memorial and Vivekananda Kendra, Mananiya Bhanudas ji, to felicitate the guests on the dais. The Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, Sri R. N. Ravi, Param Pujaniya Sar Sangha Chalak, Mananiya Dr. Mohanji Bhagavat, and Srimat Swami Chaitanya Ananda ji. from Vivekananda Ashram, Vellimalai, Kanyakumari district. I kindly pray him to shower his blessings. Please, Ji.
स्थापकाय च धर्मस्य सर्वधर्म स्वरूपिणे अवतार अरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः
சர்சங்கஜாலஜியர்களுக்கும் மேதை ஆளுநர்களுக்கும் விவேகானந்த கேந்திரத்தினுடைய தலைவர் பொதுச் செயலாளர் மற்றும் அனைத்து நிர்வாகிகளுக்கும் வருகின்றிருக்கின்ற அனைவருக்கும் அது என்பது பணிவான வணக்கம். சுவாமி விவேகானந்தர் இந்த யுகத்தினுடைய குருஷர், இந்த யுகத்தை வழிநடத்துவதற்கு என்றே அவதாரம் எடுத்தவர். சுவாமி விவேகானந்தருக்கு சக்தியை அளித்த ஸ்ரீ ராமகிருஷ்ண பரமஹம்சர் ஒரு முறை அனைவரும் சேர்ந்திருந்து ஒரு புத்தகத்தை வாசித்துக் கொண்டிருக்கும் பொழுது ஒருவர் வாசிக்கின்றார் ஜீவ தயா என்ற வார்த்தை. ராமகிருஷ்ணர் சொல்கின்றார் நான் தயா சேவா அப்படின்னு சொல்றார். சேவை செய்வதற்குத்தான் நமக்கு உரிமை உண்டு, தயை காண்பிப்பதற்கு இறைவனுக்கு மட்டுமே உரிமை உண்டு என்று சொல்கின்றார். விவேகானந்தர் அந்த அறையை விட்டு வெளியே வந்த பொழுது அவருக்கு நிறைய உண்டு. அவர் வெளியே வந்து சொல்கின்றார் இந்த ஒரு புதிய விஷயத்தை கற்றுக்கொண்டேன், எனக்கு சமயம் வரும்போது எனக்கு காலம் வரும்போது அதை அனைவருக்கும் இந்த உலகத்திற்கு பறைசாற்றுவேன் என்று சொன்னார். மனிதர்களுக்கு தொண்டு செய்வது ஜீவ சேவா சிவபூஜா என்ற தத்துவத்தை அவர் உலகெங்கும் பரப்பினார். அந்த சேவையின் அடிப்படையிலேயே விவேகானந்த கேந்திரமும் செயல்பட்டுக் கொண்டிருக்கின்றது. கேந்திர தலைவர் கூறியது போலவே ஏகநாயகி ஒரு மணி நினைவு மண்டபத்தை நிறுவியதோடு இல்லாமல் விவேகானந்த கேந்திரம் என்ற ஸ்தாபனத்தை ஆரம்பித்து அதன் மூலமாக மக்களுக்கு தொண்டு செய்யக்கூடிய அந்த பணியை ஏற்றெடுத்து அதை செயல்படுத்தினார்கள். கன்னியாகுமரி மாவட்டத்திலே எப்பொழுதெல்லாம் பேரிடர் வருகின்றதோ அப்பொழுதெல்லாம் விவேகானந்த கேந்திரம் தாராளமாக தொண்டு செய்திருக்கிறார்கள். ஓகி புயல் வந்தபோதும் சரி, கொரோனாவால் பாதிப்பு ஏற்பட்ட போதும் சரி, இப்பொழுது மழையினால் பெரிய சேதம் ஏற்பட்ட போதும் சரி, விவேகானந்த கேந்திரம் உண்மையிலேயே உடனடியாக அந்த நிவாரணத்திற்காக பொருளுதவி கொடுத்திருக்கிறார்கள். நான் திடீர் போன் பண்ணி இப்படி இருக்குது அப்படின்னு சொல்லி கனிஜிட்டு போன் பண்ணி சொன்னா உடனே ஒரு சுவாமி நீங்க தொடங்கிடுங்க நாங்க ஒன்னாந்து போயிடுவோம் அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவார். எனவே அந்த வகையிலே கன்னியாகுமரி மாவட்டத்தினுடைய மக்கள் சார்பாக விவேகானந்த கேந்திரத்திற்கு நன்றி தெரிவிக்க கடமைப்பட்டிருக்கின்றேன். அத்தகைய சேவையை செய்வதற்கு தூண்டுகோலாக இருக்கக்கூடியது விவேகானந்தருடைய அந்த வார்த்தைகள் தான். விவேகானந்தர் இந்த இடத்திற்கு வழிகாட்டியாக இருக்கின்றார் அப்படின்னு சொல்லி நாம மட்டும் இந்துக்கள் மட்டும் சொல்லல, அல்லது ஏதோ குறிப்பிட்ட கொஞ்சம் பேர் மட்டும் சொல்லல, எல்லாரும் சொல்றாங்க. முன்னாடி கொஞ்ச நாளைக்கு முன்னாடி கேரளா பக்கம் போகும்போது கம்யூனிஸ்டுடைய அந்த பிளக்ஸ்லயே விவேகானந்தருடைய படம் இருந்ததை பார்த்தேன். என்னடா இது இப்போ இப்போ விவேகானந்தர் எங்க போய் கம்யூனிஸ்ட்ல போய் சேர்ந்தார் அப்படின்னு சொல்லி. ஆனா குறை பார்த்தாச்சுன்னா அவங்க விவேகானந்தருடைய கொள்கைகளை, அதாவது மக்களுக்கு சேவை செய்கின்ற இந்த கொள்கையை ஏற்றுக்கொள்கின்றார்கள். அதனால்தான் நம்முடைய அரசாங்கம் இளைஞர் தினமாக இளைஞர்களுக்கு வழிகாட்டியாக லட்சிய புருஷனாக விவேகானந்தரை தேர்ந்தெடுத்து விவேகானந்தருடைய பிறந்த தினமாகிய ஜனவரி 12 நாள் இளைஞர் தினமாக கொண்டாட உத்தரவிட்டிருக்கின்றது. ஏனென்றால் இளைஞர்களுக்கு வழிகாட்டி விவேகானந்தர் தான். இன்றைய நம்முடைய பாரத இளைஞர்கள் தன்னம்பிக்கையற்று செயல் செய்ய முடியாது என்ற நிலையிலே இருந்து கொண்டிருக்கின்றார்கள். விவேகானந்தர் கூறுகின்றார் அப்படி இல்லை, நீ சாதாரணமான உனக்குள்ளேயே மிகப்பெரிய சக்தி இருக்கின்றது என்பதை அவர் சொன்னார். விவேகானந்தர் சொல்கின்றார், இந்த உலகத்திலே யாராவது ஒருவரால் ஒரு காரியத்தை செய்ய முடியும் என்றால் உங்கள் அனைவராலும் அந்த காரியம் செய்ய முடியும். ஒரு விவேகானந்தராக நீங்கள் உருவாக முடியும், ஒரு அப்துல் கலாம நீங்கள் உருவாக முடியும், அல்லது ஒரு சச்சின் டெண்டுல்கராக நீங்கள் உருவாக முடியும் என்ற நம்பிக்கையை அவர்களுக்கு கொடுக்கின்றார். அதனால என்ன வேணும் நமக்கு, அந்த விவேகானந்தருடைய வார்த்தைகள் நம்முடைய இளைஞர்களுக்கு சென்று சேர வேண்டும். அதே நம்முடைய அரசாங்கம் ஏற்பாடு செய்தது என்றால் இப்பொழுது இளைஞர் தினம் என்று ஒரு நாள் கொண்டாடுறதா ஏற்பாடு இருக்குது. அது எந்த அளவுக்கு எல்லா பள்ளிகளிலும் கல்லூரிகளிலும் நடக்குது அப்படின்றது எனக்கு இன்னும் உறுதியா தெரியலை. ஆனா கூட நாம பாடத்திட்டத்துல விவேகானந்தனுடைய இந்த விஷயங்களை உபதேசங்களை நமக்குள் இறைவன் இருக்கின்றான், நமக்குள் சக்தி இருக்கின்றது. நாம் சாதாரணமானவர்கள் அல்ல, நாம் பாவிகள் அல்ல, பாவிகள் என்று உங்களை அழைப்பது பாவம் என்று உட்கார்ந்து சொல்கின்றார். எனவே நாம் தெய்வீகமானவர்கள் அமலசியமுத்ரா என்ற கருத்துக்களை நாம் நம்முடைய இளைஞர்களுக்கு எடுத்து சொன்னோம் என்றால் கண்டிப்பாக நம்முடைய இளைஞர் சமுதாயம் மாறும். இன்னைக்கு எல்லாரும் சொல்றாங்க இளைஞர்கள்லாம் ஒருமனே இந்த செல்லில் கேம் விளையாடுறதுலேயே இருந்துட்டு இருக்காங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லி அவங்களுடைய ஸ்கூல் காலேஜ் எல்லாம் லீவ் விட்டுருக்காங்களா, உங்களுக்கு வேலை போற செல்லிலே செல்லில் விளையாடுறது மட்டும் இல்லை, அதனால பல லட்சம் தொலைச்சிட்டு தற்கொலை பண்றாங்க நம்முடைய மாவட்டத்திலேயே இருக்கும். ஆனால் இவர்களுக்கெல்லாம் விவேகானந்தருடைய சீலி சென்று சேர வேண்டும். அதற்கு நாம எல்லோருமே முயற்சி பண்ண வேண்டும். யாரோ ஒரு இயக்கம் போட்டால் அந்த கேந்திரமோ அல்ல RSS-ஓ முன்னணியோ அல்ல ஏதாவது ஒரு இயக்கம் செய்யும் என்று இருக்கக்கூடாது. நம் ஒவ்வொருவருக்கும் அந்த பொறுப்புள்ளது. விவேகானந்தருடைய செய்திகளை எல்லா இடத்திலும் கொண்டு செல்ல வேண்டும். விவேகானந்தர் சொல்கின்றார், உபனிஷதங்களில் இருந்து வெடிகுண்டு போல் கிளம்பி வருகின்ற வார்த்தை என்னவென்றால், மா பய, எதற்கும் பயப்படாதே, நீ சாதாரணமானவன் அல்ல என்று இந்த விஷயம் நமக்கு சொல்ல வேண்டும். ஆனா இன்னைக்கு பார்த்தாச்சுன்னா ஏதாவது ஒரு எக்ஸாம்ல சொல்லானா உடனே தூக்கு தூக்கில் ஏறிடுவாங்க, சுட்டு போறாங்க. பல லட்சம் விளையாட்டுல கேம்ஸ் வீடியோ கேம் விளையாடி இழந்துட்டாங்களா, ஒண்ணு தற்கொலை பண்ணிக்கிறாங்க. இந்த நிலை மாறணும்னா விவேகானந்தருடைய உபதேசங்கள் எல்லா இளைஞர்களுக்கும் எல்லா மக்களுக்கும் எடுத்து சொல்லி அதை நாம் அவருடைய மனதில் பதிய வைக்க வேண்டும். அந்த விஷயங்களை செய்வதற்காக விவேகானந்த கேந்திரம் நிறைய காரியங்களை செய்து கொண்டிருக்கிறார்கள். அதோடு மட்டுமல்ல, இப்பொழுது இந்த பிரம்மாண்டமான மண்டபத்தை கட்டியிருக்கிறார்கள். எனக்கு தெரிஞ்சு என்னுடைய அறிவு சரியாக இருந்தால் இந்த மாவட்டத்திலேயே இதுதான் பெரிய மண்டபமாக இருக்கும் என்று நினைக்கிறேன். இந்த மண்டபத்தை நாம் எல்லோரும் பயன்படுத்தி அவங்க சொல்லிட்டாங்க, வரவேற்புரை சொல்லும் போதே நாம் எல்லோரும் இதை பயன்படுத்திக் கொள்ளலாம் என்று நாம் பயன்படுத்தி அதன் மூலமாக நமது தொண்டர்களுக்கு அதிக உற்சாகத்தை கொடுத்து அதன் மூலமாக நம்முடைய நாடு முழுக்க ஒரு உத்வேகத்தையும் ஒரு உற்சாகத்தையும் ஒரு தன்னம்பிக்கையும் வழங்க வேண்டியது நம்முடைய கடமை, நம் ஒவ்வொருடைய கடமை. விவேகானந்த சாமி சொல்றார், பண்டைய மதங்கள் கடவுள் நம்பிக்கை இல்லாதவனே நாத்திகன் என்று கூறின. ஆனால் நான் கூறுகிறேன், யாருக்கு தன்னம்பிக்கை இல்லையோ அவன் நாத்திகன் என்று. இந்த தன்னம்பிக்கை இல்லாதவன் நாத்திகன் சொன்னா விவேகானந்த சாமி சொல்றது தன்னம்பிக்கை புஜபலமோ புத்திபலமோ இல்லை, நமக்குள்ளால் இருக்கக்கூடிய தெய்வ சக்தி. யாருக்கு எனக்குள்ளே தெய்வ சக்தி இருக்கின்றது, என்னால் எல்லாம் செய்ய முடியும் என்ற நம்பிக்கை இல்லையோ அவனே தான் தன்னம்பிக்கை இல்லாதவன் என்று சொல்கின்றார். அந்த தெய்வ சக்தி எனக்குள் இருக்கின்றது என்பதை புரிந்து கொண்டு யார் செயல்படுகின்றார்களோ அவர்கள் தான் ஆத்திகள் என்று சொல்கின்றார். பொதுவாக சொல்றது உண்டு, இந்த தன்னம்பிக்கை பற்றி சொல்லும் போது நான் ஒரு கதை சொல்றேன், அந்த கதையை சொல்லி முடிச்சிருக்கேன். ஒரு வீடு கணவன் மனைவி படுத்திருந்தாங்கோ ஒரு அறையில கட்டில படுத்திருந்தாங்கோ, ஒரு 12 மணி இருக்கும், திடீர்னு மனைவி எழுந்திட்டா, பார்த்தாங்க கீழே ஒரு பாம்பு கொஞ்சம் பயந்துட்டாங்க. அப்ப என்ன பண்ணாங்க, பத்து கணவன் படுத்திருக்கா அகத்தை எழுப்பி சொல்லிடுவோம் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு கணவன் எழுப்புறாங்க, சத்தம் போட்டு அப்படினா பாம்பு மேல வந்துருக்கோம். அவர் எழுப்புற மாதிரி இப்படி படுத்துனா இப்படி நேரம் மாத்தி படுத்திட்டார். திரும்பியும் எழுப்பினாங்க, அவர் எழுந்தினார், எழுந்து கழுது என்னன்னு கேட்டார். அப்போ மனைவி சொன்னாங்க, இவரும் அங்க போய் பார்த்தார், அந்த சைடு கட்டில இருந்துட்டு கீழே பாக்குறார், பார்க்கும்போது அந்த பாம்பு போயிட்டு இருக்கு. மனைவி நினைச்சாங்க இவர் ஓடி போய் கம்படுத்திட்டு வந்து அடிப்பாரு. ஆனா அந்த மனுஷன் ஒரு அழகான விஷயம் சொன்னார், அந்த கணவன் என்ன சொன்னார்னா, ஐயோ பாம்பு பக்கத்து வீட்டுல யாராவது ஆம்பிள்ள இருப்பான் கூட்டிட்டு வா அப்படின்னா. எனக்கு மறந்துட்டு நானும் அப்படிங்கிறது. அதே மாதிரி தான் நம்முடைய இளைஞர் சமுதாயம், இளைஞர்களும் இளைஞர்கள் தன்னுடைய பலத்தை அறியாமல் மயங்கி இருக்கின்றார்கள். அந்த மேட்டத்தை மாற்றுவதற்கு விவேகானந்தருடைய உபதேசங்கள் எல்லா இடத்திலும் சென்று பரவ வேண்டும். அதற்கு இந்த மண்டலம் மிக உறுதுணையாக இருக்க வேண்டும் என்று நான் ஸ்ரீராமகிருஷ்ணரை பிரார்த்திக்கின்றேன். அதன் மூலமாக நாம் எல்லோரும் வீழ்ச்சி பெற்று அதி விரைவிலேயே அகண்ட பாரதத்தை, பாரதம் பாரின் குருவாக இருப்பதை நம் கண்ணிலேயே காண வேண்டும். என் விவேகான் சாமி கூறுகின்றார், அதோ என்னுடைய அன்னை அரியாசனத்தில் அமர்ந்து விட்டால் போர் அலங்கார பூஷிதையாக உலகை வழிநடத்துவதாக உலகின் ராணியாக அமர்ந்திருக்கின்றார் என்று. அந்த காட்சி நம்முடைய வாழ்விலேயே நினைவாக வேண்டும். அதற்காக நாம் எல்லோருமே தொண்டு செய்ய வேண்டும். தொண்டு செய்யணும் அப்படின்னு சொல்லும் போது இன்னைக்கு முழுநேர ஊழியர்கள் நிறைய இடத்துல இந்த சன்னியாசிகள் எல்லாரும் மதிக்கிறாங்க, நமஸ்காரம் பண்றாங்க. ஆனா தன்னுடைய குழந்தை சன்னியாசம் ஆகணும்னு சொல்லி யாரும் பிரார்த்தனை பண்ணவே இல்லை. கடவுள் டாக்டர் ஆகணும், இன்ஜினியர் ஆகணும், கலெக்டர் ஆகணும் பிரார்த்தனை பண்றாங்க, யாரும் சன்னியாசி ஆகணும் பிரார்த்தனை இல்லை. ஆனால் அந்த நிலையை நாம மாற்ற வேண்டும். நம்முடைய வாரிசு ஒருவர் சன்னியாசியாக வேண்டும் அல்லது முழுநேர ஊழியராக வேண்டும். இதுதான் ஒரு இடத்துக்கு கொஞ்ச வருஷமாவது கேந்திராவிலேயோ அல்லது சங்கத்திலேயோ இன்னும் ஏதாவது ஒரு இடத்துல கொஞ்ச வருஷமாவது ஒரு அஞ்சு வருஷமாவது முழுநேர ஊழியராக வேலை செய்ய வேண்டும் என்று நாம் பிரார்த்தனை செய்ய வேண்டும். அவர்களுக்கு அப்படியே நாம் சிறுவர்களிருந்தே ஊட்டி வர வேண்டும். அவ்வாறு செய்தோம் என்றால் நம்முடைய காலத்திலேயே அகண்ட பாரதத்தை பாரின் குருவாக அன்னை இருப்பதை நாம் தரிசிக்க முடியும். அதற்கு இறைவன் அருள் புரியட்டும். வணக்கம்.
ஸ்ரத்தேய சுவாமி சைத்தன்யானந்தஜி, ஆதரணீய பாலகிருஷ்ணஜி, ஆதரணீய பானுஜாஜி, உபஸ்தித் சஜ்ஜன், மாதா பகினி, டுடே வி ஆர் ஹியர் டு இனாகுரேட் அண்ட் டெடிகேட் திஸ் எக்ஸலண்ட்லி கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்டட் சபாகிருஹ வித் திஸ் ஆகஸ்ட் கேதரிங் and the auspicious year of 75th year of independence. The joy of this occasion fills our heart, and it is quite natural. Most of us are in some way or other related to this activity of Vivekananda Kendra. And therefore, it is very natural for us, if something new is constructed, some new amenity is created, we are delighted, as we should be. But we should also remember, men, money and ammunition, these are the three factors which lead to success in any endeavor. And after the men exert and work, other things, money and ammunition follows. So it is very natural, after so many years of working, the Vivekananda Kendra campus here is having a magnificent Sabhagriha. But that is the result of hard work of so many men. You see, this infrastructure and other amenities, they are always there. But there is some inspiration in that. When that inspiration is there, it cannot be constructed by cement or bricks. It has to be imparted by the selfless efforts, tapasya of men. This southernmost point of the Bharatiya mainland is Kanyakumari, and very famous and very inspiring for us because Bhagavati Kanyakumari performed a penance here. The Vivekananda Rock Memorial and this campus is not merely a piece of excellent construction. It is the place of working and thinking of the workers of Vivekananda Kendra, who are selflessly going all over India to rid our brethren of their perils. they are working selflessly. So, lakhs of people annually come here and visit. They visit the campus, they visit the rock. And they not merely appreciate the scenery and the fineness of construction, they also get inspired. Many of them get active after returning. That power, that life force has been enthused through the entire things here, because work is going on. And all the money and ammunition is worthy because it is invested in that work only, and work progresses due to that. So it is our responsibility now. We have created one more amenity. All of us, not merely those who have some responsibility in Vivekananda Kendra, those who consider themselves as friends of the Kendra, those who are contributing in some way or other, even by merely well-wishing, the new responsibility is there now for all of us. We have to strive hard. We are all like-minded people. We know about the mind and matter and manner and the models the Vivekananda Kendra has created. That mind, it must expand, it must, in its wake, it must carry everybody in our country. The matter they take care of should be taken care of by the society. It should become work of the society, not merely a Kendra work. The manner in which we do it should be the manner of the Hindu society, should become the manner of Hindu society. And the model we have created here on this small scale, all Hindu society should be model of that service, that swagauravam. In the 75th year of our independence, the swa is very important thing. Swami Vivekananda started by that preaching that swa. That swa should be strengthened. Second thing he told us about is strength. Weakness is sin. So our society should be strong. Our society should be aware of its self-glory, should be aware of the responsibilities entailed with that self-glory. And we should strive hard to carry out the God-given duty in the world life imparted to Bharat by the Almighty. That is giving dharma. Dharma that balances everything. Dharma that connects everything. Dharma that uplifts everything. Dharma that creates peace and bliss. World needs it. World is craving for it. Whole world is looking at Bharat. Swami Vivekananda is the fountainhead of the renaissance of modern Bharat. That renaissance happens when there is need for Sanatan Dharma. And therefore, whole Bharat should be one living model of Sanatan Dharmic life. And world should learn from Bharat. That sort of Bharat we have to create. We have struggled hard. We have created men. We got the money, we got the ammunition. It should be used for the same purpose effectively and selflessly. This is created by the Kendra. But the president says that this is for whole of the Hindu society. with that spirit, we have to skillfully use all these amenities so that the work for which they were created progresses. In this moment of delight, we should remember that duty also and prepare us for the greater weight we have by creation of this amenity, shoulder. We have to carry it to the last destination of our journey. We should be prepared for that. And everybody must think that this is an amenity, this is also a responsibility. And that responsibility belongs to every one of us assembled here. So everybody assembled here should think in this manner. With these words, I thank you for inviting me here as a guest. Actually, I come here each year and I am not a guest here, but today they have asked me to sit here as a guest. So I have to speak like a guest. So I offer my congratulations, offer like a guest, offer you promise of every assistance, which is not actually needed, the promise, and complete my words. Thank you very much.
Conducting 1 month residential Acharya Prashikshan Shibir at Kanyakumari. In that, All India Vice President of Vivekananda Rock Memorial and Vivekananda Kendra, Mananiya Nivedita Didi, gives a series of lecture on Indian culture. It was the earnest desire of all the principals and teachers of VKVs to bring it out in a book form. And thus, today we have the release of that book on the mission of human evolution, Indian culture, challenges and potentialities. During sessions on Indian culture, questions often asked by youth indicate deep interest in and sometimes a lack of clarity about the subject. Hence this book. In 6 parts and several chapters, it takes us on a journey to understand the fundamentals of Indian culture. Vision of life, values of life and systems of life, the causes for the degradation and the road ahead, not in isolation but in the context of other cultures. As in a journey, there are stations, brief and purposeful pauses, so in this book. It pauses in between for crucial consideration, marked sections in the chapters to examine the gap between the ideals and our practice. It helps us reflect and where necessary rectify our approach. It pauses again for targeted questions and vision-based answers, questions that youth ask, sometimes genuine but often out of confusion created by Western frameworks, and hence they are vision-based. But these are passes for the ultimate destination, human evolution, and so the book looks at the world scenario, India's mission, and how we can respond and contribute to it at the civilizational and individual levels. This book is meant for all those who are keen to understand and incorporate more consciously and deeply the eternal principles of Indian culture into their daily routines and professions, families and surroundings. It is for all those who believe that our lives have a greater purpose and it is inextricably linked with the mission and destiny of India. Now I request the Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, Shri R. N. Ravi, to release the book and Param Pujaniya Sar Sangachalak, Mananiya Dr. Mohanji Bhagavat, to receive the first copy. I request Mananiya Anumantarawji, the Vice President of Vivekananda Rock Memorial and Vivekananda Kendra, to give the books to the distinguished guests. The book will be available at a special price of rupees 300. Please visit their bookstall to buy it. Now let us have Ekal Geet to mark a tribute to the legendary hero Swami Vivekananda. Kumari Anush Kumari of 11th standard will sing a solo song.
Anandamayam suvivekamayam swanandamayam bhuvanamandale navayugamudayatu sada vivekanandamayam suvivekamayam swanandamayam tamomayam janajivanamaduna nishkriyatalasya krestam rajo Mihatam Bhakti Jnana Karma Vijnanai Bhakti Jnana Karma Vijnanai Bhavatu Sattviko Dyotamayam Sada Vivekanandamayam Suvivekamayam Swanandamayam Bhuvana Mandale Navayugamudayatu Sada Vivekanandamayam Suvivekamayam Swanandamayam Valhi Vayu Chalapala Vivartakam Pancha Bhautikam Vijnanam Salilaniti Talam Gaganamandalam Karathala Palamiva Kurvanam Dikshu Vikirnam Manuja Kulaminam Dikshu Vikirnam Katayatu Jaika Kutumbamayam Sada Vivekanandamayam Suvivekamayam Swanandamayam Bhuvana Mandale Navayugamudayatu Sada Vivekanandamayam Suvivekamayam Swanandamayam Sagunakaram Bhagunakaram Ekakaram Bhajanti Ete Bhajantu Devam Swasvanishtaya Vimachyam Vishwadharma Mimam Udharamavam Pravartayatu Sauhartamayam Sada Vivekanandamayam Suvivekamayam Swanandamayam Bhuvana Mandale Navayugamudayatu Sada Vivekanandamayam Suvivekamayam Swanandamayam Jive Jive Shivaswarupam Sada Bhavayatu Sevayam Srimadujitam Mahamanavam Shamarchayatu Nija Pujayam Charatu Manavuyam Sukhitakaram Charatu Manavuyam Sukhitakaram Dharmam Sevatyakamayam Sada Vivekanandamayam Suvivekamayam Swanandamayam Bhuvana Mandale Navayugamudayatu Sada Vivekanandamayam Suvivekamayam Swanandamayam Suvivekamayam Swanandamayam
Thank you, Anush Kumari. Today we are greatly privileged by the presence of the Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, Sri R. N. Ravi, with us. I humbly request his good self to deliver the inaugural address.
Hari Om. Vichar Parivar Pramukh Paramadarniye Sri Mohanji Bhagavat Sraddhaya Chaitanyanandaji, Vivekananda Kendra President, Sri Balakrishnanji, General Secretary, Bangaji, Bhaiyaji, other distinguished personalities present here and all the members of this magnificent Hindu family. On this auspicious occasion of inauguration of the Sabhagriham, Anaivankum Kane Vanakam. At the outset, I pay my earnest tribute to this sacred soil of Kanyakumari, where Swami Vivekananda received the divine message of awakening Bharat. The soul of Bharat was tormented, suppressed, oppressed for nearly 800 years. And it was seeking a liberation. And that divine message of Bharat Mata came to Swami Vivekananda at this very place. And so this is a sacred place for all of us. I would also like to pay my earnest tribute to Mananiya Sri Eknath Ji Ranade and lakhs of Bhartiyas, people those who worked and made it possible to have the Vivekananda Rock Memorial, a place of pilgrimage for all the Bhartiyas, a place of pilgrimage and a source of inspiration. And also for creating Vivekananda Kendra and taking its branches to the remote corners of this country, far-flung areas, forgotten, abandoned by all. In those areas, remote areas, to carry the message of Vivekananda for national awakening. Vivekananda Kendra has been doing an human service to Bharat to fulfill the dream of Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda's dream of Bharat was a Bharat, the world leader, the Vishnu Guru, materially prosperous, militarily strong, intellectually superior, and spiritually imbued with the Vishwa Bandhutva, embrace the world in its arm as a family. But that Bharat could be possible only if the long suppressed soul of Bharat was liberated. Because all these centuries, whether the invaders from the Central Asia or Europe, they tried their utmost to destroy the sense of soul, what Paramahansa Mohanji just said about soul, the sense of a being a Bharatiya, a proud Bharatiya. They had done their utmost to destroy it. They destroyed and sought to destroy the institutions which nourished and preserved that sense of soul, the sense of Bhartiyata. Bharat has been known, and its identity is not decided or determined by the kings and kingdoms, but its eternal cultural spirituality, Sanatan, Sanskriti and Adhyatma, which permeates from south to north, east to west, the entire country. There have been numerous kings and kingdoms, but Bhartiya Samaj, the Indian society, has been one. Our cultural and spiritual icons have been one. Whether it is Kanyakumari or in Kamrup or Kashmir or Kutch, any part that we go. Sri Ram, though born in Ayodhya, is in the heart of every Bharatiya. Sri Krishna was born in Mathura Vrindavan and later stationed at Dwarka, but he was, or he is old and lives in the heart of every Bharatiya. Any part you go, you find their presence in the heart of the people. People of Bharat were not bound by kingdoms and kings. They moved from one end to the other for pilgrimage, for education, without any restraint, constraint, no visa, no passport, no control, no taxation. People move from one end to the other. When a Pallava prince in 5th century from Kanchipuram went to Nalanda to study, round about the same time when Vasubandhu from Gandhar, which is after Islamic invasion and control, became Peshawar, he came to Nalanda to study. When Kumarin Bhatt from Kashmir came to study, for them it was a seamless travel. They didn't need anyone's permission or anyone's approval. They all came, they studied. When 700 years back, Mahapurush Shankar Deva started from Kamrup and came to Rameshwaram, which was a center of great center of learning, and he studied there. Later on he went to Kashi, studied there, returned to Kamrup, and he composed Dhanya Dhanya Bharat Bhumi. He didn't need anyone's permission. He traveled. When about over 500 years back, Guru Nanak Devji came again to Rameshwaram. It was, and traveled rest of the country. It was a seamless journey, as if there were no kings, there were no kingdoms. It was one Bharat. This sense of oneness was targeted by the invaders and colonizers. And they started targeting the institutions that nourished, that sustained them. And the most important institution was the temples. Temples were not just a mere place of worship. It was the center of the entire society. It was a center of learning. It was a center of collective decision making. Whenever a problem confronted a village, elders collected there and took a decision. It was a center for dispute resolutions. It was a center for health and well-being because Vaidyashala, Vaidya were attached there. It was also a place where the travelers coming from one end to the other could stay as long as needed, rest and recuperate before it takes the forward journey. It was the micro universe of the Hindu society. It became the target, and it went through massive destructions. Some destroyed it physically, others by choking the source of nourishment and sustenance. And later, they also did a most dangerous thing, that they divided this one organic entity temple into secular and religious part. A part of this became secular, misplaced, misguided definition of secularism, and only Garbhagriha remained a sacred place. These were all machinations, all designs to destroy the institution that nourished the sense of swa, sense of Bhartiyata among all the Bhartiyas. They destroyed their traditional education system and created a modern schools, and schools designed on the model to create the generations of Indian in the pure imitation of the British. They wrote voluminous literature about Bharat, denigrating, denouncing all that was Bhartiya. And students in schools and colleges began learning those texts. They also invented a discipline called anthropology. There was no anthropology before. And there is no anthropology for white people. It is only for colonized people. And they started documenting minor differences between people living at one place and people living at some other place. How they wear dhoti, how they eat their food, the language that they speak. They created communities. They invented a theory of race. Aryan came from outside, Aryan, Dravid. They did everything possible to destroy the soul of Bharat. Of course, they also, through the Act of British Parliament, they mandated upon themselves to evangelize Bharat, saying that Bhartiyas were deprived of religion and they were morally depraved because they did not accept, they did not have the gospel. So it was under the India Charter Act of 1813, it became a mandate. A reference which has been made by Sister Nivedita in her book. It's a beautiful book, and I would recommend that everyone who wishes to understand Bhartiya Sanskriti, Bhartiyata, should read this book. It is a well-researched book and very, very enlightening. And I congratulate her for producing this book. Unfortunately, after the British left, the leadership of our country was in the hands of people, those were well-meaning, good people. But unfortunately, they did not look at Bharat from the Bhartiya's perspective. They continued looking at Bharat from the British perspective, from the European perspective, from the Western perspective. Our development model was based on Western perspective. Instead of a vision, that what vision which Swami Vivekananda had for Bharat, it became a 5-year action plan. The government would come for 5 years. First year we'll go into preparing the plan. Next 2 years or so for implementing it. By 4th year, again, because election comes, again populist measures. And that's how. As a result, development was ad hoc. Some areas prospered relatively better. Some areas were left far behind. It was uneven. It created regional imbalances. Since they continued looking at Bharat from that perspective, again, it continued looking at people divided in various communities, various sects, various castes. It did not look at Bharat as one. As a result, for certain populist reasons and motives, numerous groups emerged. Minority, majority, minority, within minorities, the smaller minority, backward, forward, backward, again within backward, most backward, other backward. River. The society continued getting divided and becoming disharmonious. Even yesterday, in Nagaland, the state where I was before, they have created, Nagaland government has created yet another tribe and given an area for them to stick this in your tribe, take your tribe. If you keep dividing, there's no end to it. A tree has million leaves and no two leaves are alike. Nature does not replicate exactly. But if the look is, the attitude is to look each leaf differently, then there is a chaos. The organic connect with the tree, so long it is missing, it is a recipe for chaos and anarchy. And that is what was happening to our country. And for any problem that we faced, suppose there was, if the development was not at the desired pace or some areas were behind than others, immediately people would blame, say that this is the Indian culture, so there are cultural issues. When economy was not growing, they coined a word, expression. The Western people coined it and our own economists adopted it, Hindu rate of growth. When there is a fundamental flaw in the outlook, the way you look at Bharat, and when you formulate its policy, the flaw is there. But because of the bad policies, when the development is not taking place at the desired pace, then there is sort of slow pace of growth, the blame goes to Hindu rate of growth. And it has started being quoted everywhere, Europe, America, even in India. Then there is absence of cleanliness. Okay, Hindu way of life, they don't mind. It's all filth, after all, they are all looking for life beyond, so they don't bother for filth in this life. Every aspect of life, it was made to appear that everything in Bharat was bad. And everything was because of the Hindu philosophy, Hindu way of life. Now, what has happened in the last 7 years? Look at what has happened. all that has happened is under a dynamic and capable leadership, the vision is different. Vision is not 5 year, 3 year, 2 year. Vision is 100 years. What this Bharat would be in 2047? Where this country should be? By the time we complete 100 years of our independence. And planning, execution, all goes in that way. Look at how the economy is galloping. Now, where is this old phrase of Hindu rate of growth? What will they say now? If you are doing better than most of the countries in the world, why? Cleanliness. About 7 years back, 60% of Bharat used to go for open defecation. Very embarrassing. And whenever someone talked about it, when Prime Minister for the first time in 2014 on the 2nd of October, he took up the broom and said, Swachh Bharat, people mocked. I said, it's a cultural issue, people will not. Now where are we? It's almost open defecation free country. We proudly, incredible things achieved with the cooperation, with the support of all, because the movement, the decision and the execution is vision centric, not short term and visual centric. Matri Shakti. In our country, gender ratio was so twisted. More number of male, less number of female, and in some areas it was the disparity was growing because of various reasons. Now the initiative that began with Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, and subsequent various measures, though the census is yet to be completed and result to be out, but samples done reveals that now the gender ratio has reversed. This Matri Shakti waking up this half of Bharatiyas, bringing them at par, if not above, to make this Sampurna Bharat as a partner, Sabka Saath, Sabka Viswas, Se Sabka Vikas. Opening the frontiers which were banned for the women, the last bastion was the defense. Now our daughters are flying the jet fighters, bombers. They are doing as good as their male counterpart. The waking up Bharat, the waking up Matri Shakti. In the realm of our national security and national defense, all these years, we have been very, very defensive. We have been very, very inward looking. When Mumbai attack happened, and for 52 hours, the whole country felt humiliated and insulted by a handful of terrorists coming from Pakistan. Within a few months, the then leadership went at Sharm el Sheikh in Egypt and joined declaration with the Prime Minister of Pakistan that terrorism has affected both the countries. It was extreme humiliation. What happened when Pulwama happened? When Pulwama happened, the enemy was hit deep inside in their own home through surgical strike. No more. We are not going to tolerate that you will have to pay a heavier cost. The Bharat is not the same as it was to, it used to be. You can't take it lightly. Earlier, in our northern neighbor, they had a tendency to encroach, neglect, capture. In 1957-58, when they took Aksai Chin, a large part of Bharat Mata, and when there was a furor in parliament, anger in parliament, the country was angry. The then Prime Minister said, that is a rocky desert and not a blade of grass grows there. In 2020, in that very area in June, in Galwan, if you look at it, by the way, earlier it was looked at, it was a rocky desert, the same rocky desert. When the adversary wanted to move forward, we pushed them back and we paid the price. 12 brave sons of Bharat Mata gave their life to defend that land, because for us, it is Bharat is not a mere geography. Every inch of it is a part of our body of Bharat Mata. And we'll pay the price, whatever price needed, to defend that. When Doklam happened, for 74 days, when Chinese army tried to push forward, we stopped them. I said, okay, go back. Go back to your line, you have no business to come. They made a lot of human crying. Tensions escalated. They went around the world telling this, all the big fives, that look, India is provoking a war situation. We, with cool, calm head, kept our army, military, our air force, all ready, defended the land, and after 74 days, they had to go back. So this is loud and clear. It's an issue of our Swabhiman. We cannot let people just take us lightly as they were taking. In every aspect, the Bharat country is rising. It is, as Paramadhariya Mohanji said, period of renaissance. It is a renaissance. Some people are yet to come to terms with it, but I'm sure they too will come to terms with it. The Bharat will grow to its destiny to be the world leader, materially prosperous, militarily strong, intellectually superior, and spiritually Vishubandhutva. Right now, the major crisis that has affected the world has again made it very clear that who could be the world leader of tomorrow. One is climate change. Most of these developed countries who are responsible for climate destruction, who are responsible for all that is upheavals which is happening in the because of destruction of environment, reckless exploitation of resources of the earth, because of the anthropocentric view of life. Anthropocentric view of life, it says, humans are at the center of creation and rest of this creation universe is for the enjoyment of human. This led to the reckless destruction and exploitation of resources of earth. And as a result, Mother Earth is in pain, is in torment. And we are getting the, you know, this a small demonstration of what is going to happen tomorrow. curtain measures in terms of major catastrophe that is happening in different parts of the world. It is Bharat again and Bharatiya leadership that took the decision that no, we will show the world by demonstration how we can move away from hydrocarbon to clean energy. We move away not just as a matter of artificial policy, but as a necessity, but as our belief that we are not at the center of creation, but we are a part of creation. In 2016, the Prime Minister set the goal that by 2025, India will have 100 gigawatt of clean energy. And look at where we are. Last year, September, we have already crossed 100 gigawatt. 4 years before the target. This is our energy. This is our collective will. This is the leadership, vision, and the strength of 135 crore Bharatiyas. International Solar Alliance, a new concept. So look, sun god has so much of energy, it can sustain us for endless years. Why do you have to go to and burn the resources, the hydrocarbon? Now today we are over 50 gigawatt of power that we generate our solar energy. So India's leadership in saving the planet is now visible, is obvious. Another crisis which confronted the whole world is COVID. When the COVID struck, we all felt that now this is the time when the countries, the developed countries, those who have been so materialistic, they have been so inward looking as if the whole world is for them to exploit and just for them to develop. If some compassion for humanity would emerge and they would be coming forward, forthcoming to help the poor countries with the vaccines. But what happened? Within months, by the time they discovered the vaccine, a concept came, vaccine nationalism. The countries, advanced countries who produced the vaccine, they started promoting their own vaccine companies. It was Bharat that not only produced a vaccine, but shared the vaccine with more than 100 countries in the world under the Maitri scheme. Now, the message is clear where Bharat is going and how the world order which emerged after Second World War, at the time when Bharat was not a Swadhin, was not an independent country, was still a colony. And so this order has been outrightly unfair and iniquitous as far as Bharat and other countries, also rest of the other countries, those who are behind, they are all concerned. Now this inadequacy, the failure of the existing world order has become obvious in climate change, in the COVID situation, and also the fact that there is so much weapons of mass destruction which have been created by countries, so-called powerful countries. Now, Bharat is poised in this challenged world. Bharat is poised to be the world leader in all aspects. Look at when the Prime Minister launched the scheme of Startup India, innovations, our hundreds and thousands of our scientists are going and building future of other countries, developed countries. because we didn't create environment for them. They looked as if they are not welcome here, so they had to go. Each of them have a pain. They like to come and serve this country, but we didn't provide them opportunity. And when the opportunities were provided, and when these policies creating that a conducive ecosystem was created, look at the best of entrepreneurship. In the last year alone, more than 10,000 startups. We are soon going to have to hit a century of unicorn startup. Unicorn is when a startup which is a new one, experiment with a new idea, and when its net worth is over $1 billion, that is almost about 8,000 crores, that is unicorn. We are going to have about 100 unicorn in India. Our people have enormous potential. The need was to look at this Bharat from the eyes of Bharat, with a sense of Bharatiyata, and take it to the destiny to fulfill the dream of Swami Vivekananda to make it the world leader. I would like to thank all of you present here, especially the Karyakartas of Vivekananda Kendra, those who have been doing the human service. I wish them all the best. And let us all rise up, let us all commit ourselves to build this new Bharat, make it the world leader in the next about 24 years, by the time 2047 comes. Many of us, if not all, would be there to see that when the world looks up to Bharat as a savior of the humanity, the savior of the planet. With this, I conclude. Romba Mandri, thank you very much. Jai Bharat.
Thank you, sir. In one of the alumni meetings, the idea of construction of this auditorium, Swami Vivekananda Sabhagriham, was discussed. Srimati Lakshmi Prabha, the second batch student of VKV, and her husband, Sri Gananathan, PEB expert, came forward to contribute for the construction of the auditorium. Our alumni and parents were appealed for the contribution, and of course, most of them contributed to take this opportunity to appeal to the parents and the alumni to contribute for the same cause. And it's only because of the untiring support and guidance of Mananiya Balakrishnan ji, the All India President of Vivekananda Rock Memorial and Vivekananda Kendra, this Sabhagriham could be inaugurated today. Now it is time to acknowledge the General Secretary of Vivekananda Rock Memorial and Vivekananda Kendra, Mananiya Baludas ji.
Rama Swarupini Avatara Varishthaya Ramakrishnaya Te Namaha. Namaskar to all present here. You all witnessed the grand inauguration of Vivekananda Sabhagriham and in the Prana Bhavan by Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, Sri Arindra Viji, in the presence of Param Pujaniya Sasankatalak and Dr. Mohan Bhagwat ji and Shraddheya Swami Itanananda ji of Vivekananda Ashram, Nellimalai. The Vivekananda Sabhagriham has been dedicated to nation for remaining all the time Sada Vivekanandamayam, and also for the man-making and nation-building activities through Vivekananda Kendra and Vivekananda Kendra Vidyalaya, and for that we are grateful and express our gratitude to Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, Dr. Mohan Bhagwat ji, Param Pujaniya Sasankatalak ji, and Swami Chaitanyananda ji. in their addresses, they have given us a guidance which will be very, very helpful to us. We are also grateful to Honorable Governor for releasing the book on the mission of human evolution, Indian culture, challenges and potentialities, written by Raniya Nimita Didi, and it is open to all of you to be always in the line of man-making nation building and Sada Vivekanandamayam. We have with us Madam Governor, and we express our deepest gratitude to her. We have Shri Bhayaji Joshi, former Sarakaryavaha of Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangha, Dr. N. Lakshmikumari Didi, former President of Vivekananda Kendra, Shri Shri Dharvimboji, and various Sangha Adhikaris and important people in Nagarkoil and Chennai also, who with their special presence have graced the occasion. We express our gratitude to all of them. We express our thanks to the collector of Kanyakumari district, the superintendent of police Kanyakumari district, the security and police personnel, and also various officers from district administration as well as from governor's office for gracing the occasion. We are thankful to the alumni of Vivekananda Kendra Vidyalaya who initially thought about this bhavan. They contributed their mite, which was supported by many donors. We are thankful to all of them. We also express our gratitude to the members of the general body, parents, students, staff of Vivekananda Kendra Vidyalaya, and also of Vivekananda Rock Memorial and Vivekananda Kendra, and also various Kendra Karyakartas and Swayamsevaks of Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangha for making this program a great success. We also owe our gratitude to architect Kanyatharji, who extended free services for designing this building, Shri Murgeshanji, the contractor, and Shri Ananda Thambreji, the artist, for his 5 paintings. We are also grateful to media personnel, the Tamil Nadu Electricity Board, and various other service providers for their total support for the program. We once again thank you all, making this program a great success. Pranam, Namaskar.
Jay.